Happy New Year to everyone. Today, I'll be sharing with you a synopsis of Barbados' economic performance in 2011 and the prognosis for 2012 and beyond. The Barbadian economy remained stable in 2011 in a climate of undiminished international economic uncertainty. Foreign exchange spending of $5.5 billion was financed almost entirely from tourist inflows, earnings from the international business and financial services sector, exports, and capital inflows. As a result, there was a minimal need to draw on the central bank's foreign exchange reserves, which fell by only 1% between the end of 2010 and December 2011. The Barbados currency remains well protected, with foreign reserve cover of 18 weeks of imports at December 2011, comfortably above the international norm of 12 weeks. The fiscal deficit has been reduced from 7.4% to 4.8% of GDP for April to December, in line with the revised targets of government's medium-term fiscal strategy. The MTFS sets out policies designed to achieve a balanced budget by 2016-2017. This fiscal strategy is sustainable, as evidenced by the following. One, the cost of servicing the external debt will absorb less than 10% of foreign exchange earnings for the remainder of this decade. Two, there is no need to refinance a major borrowing on the international financial markets until 2021. Three, the annual interest cost of the total debt, domestic and foreign, is manageable at 22% of government tax and other revenues. And four, maturing domestic debt may be refinanced without difficulty because there remains considerable excess liquidity in the economy. The ratio of debt to GDP for all of government, including statutory corporations, is 47.3%. Financing from the NIS for 2012 is projected at approximately 38% of government's financing needs. The extent of the NIS purchases of government debt is prudent, in view of the investment options available to the fund. Alternative domestic investments available to NIS are all riskier than government securities and are in limited supply, while investments elsewhere in the Caribbean region may be subject to exchange rate risks as well as country risk. Investment returns in US dollars, euros, and sterling are uncertain, and the yields are too low to give NIS the revenue it needs to meet its obligations. What is more, it is not in the interest of national development that NIS should use foreign exchange to invest abroad, in preference to investment in the domestic economy. The immediate policy priority has been to ride out the international economic storm and keep the economy stable. However, there has been a little growth, estimated at 0.5%. Tourist numbers have increased, but length of stay and average spending have fallen, leading to an increase in tourism output that was marginal at 0.3%. Over the past decade, Barbados was able to maintain its share of expenditure in the Caribbean tourism market by virtue of its competitive edge in the top end of the market. There was no significant expansion in the international business and financial services sector or in exports, and the public sector was constrained in stimulating the economy by the need for fiscal consolidation. Apart from tourism, the growth sectors were construction, 4.4%, and transport and communications 0.6%. The lingering effects of the international recession have dried up business cash flow and reduced profitability, leading to additional job losses. Consequently, the average unemployment rate for 2011 is estimated at about 12%. The sectors mainly affected were manufacturing and small business. High oil and commodity prices continued to drive up inflation, which reached 8.7% in October. The economic prospects. Barbados's tourism remains competitive because the country is known internationally as a high-quality destination. In order to maintain a competitive edge in tourism, the industry must attain and maintain international standards at all times. New investment in luxury accommodation and amenities such as the Four Seasons, Lime Grove, and Port Ferdinand strengthens Barbados's international competitiveness. Further investment is needed in refurbishment and upgrades of hotels and tourism facilities, including the cultural and historical legacy of the country. Completing the upgrade of financial regulation and the extension of Barbados's network of double taxation agreements are key actions being used to spur new growth in international business and financial services. The prospects for agriculture and agro-industry depend on the development of an integrated strategy which includes a range of traditional and new products and focuses on products and linkages which have high value added in Barbados. IDB finance programs for alternative energy use are another important source of potential growth and foreign exchange savings. The growth prospects for 2012 are tempered by the unsettled international climate, but the medium-term growth prospects are encouraging once the international economy settles down. The growth rate in 2012 may be 1% or less, unless the international economic and financial climate improves. Construction of tourism facilities and government's housing initiatives are expected to be the main drivers. In the medium term, growth rates of 2-3% are possible, provided the strategies mentioned earlier are successfully implemented. The economy remains stable, and foreign exchange inflows are expected to cover imports and other foreign payments as in 2011. The foreign reserve cover is expected to remain about 18 weeks of imports. The key to maintaining macroeconomic stability is strict adherence to the targets of the medium-term fiscal strategy. Good day and best wishes to everyone.